Welcome back to our channel Prash. Learning is fun. In this module, I am going to derive formula for refractive index of prism from physics under the topic refraction. First, let us see what is a prism. A prism is a transparent medium separated from the surrounding medium by at least two plane surfaces, which are inclined at a certain angle. It contains two triangular bases and three rectangular plane surfaces. These are the rectangular plane surfaces. One, we have two and three rectangular plane surfaces and two triangular bases. This is triangular base, one side, and this is the other side. When a ray of light is incident on one plane surface, it emerges out from other side. Other plane surface. You can see this. A ray is entering from one surface and leaving the prism from other surface. Place a prism on a sheet of white paper and draw an outline of the prism. Now, represent this as P, Q, R. Angle between PQ and PR is angle of prism A. PQ is one plane surface, PR is another plane surface. Let us assume a light ray is incident on a plane surface PQ. So an incident ray is striking the prism at point M. At this point M, I will draw a perpendicular line. This perpendicular line acts as a normal to that surface. So this is an incident ray. The angle between this incident ray and M is called angle of incidence I1. Now this ray gets refracted in the prism. So passes through the prism. This ray passes through the refracts and passes through the prism and meets on the other surface. Let us take this point as N. From this point N, the ray emerges out. So this is my emergent ray is the ray that comes out from the prism. Now at this point N, I will draw a normal. Normal is always perpendicular to the plane surface. So if I draw this, becomes my normal, and this angle of the angle between the normal and the emergent ray will become my angle of emergence I2. Now this is the incident ray at M, so this will be the refracted ray. So R1 be the angle of refraction at this point M, and this ray is incident ray for the second surface. So this angle of incidence I am taking it as R2, and this ray is coming out of the prism, so this angle is called as angle of emergence, that is I2. Now I will extend this incident ray and emergent ray. So let me extend this incident ray. So I have to extend these two rays such that these two rays meet at a point. Let this point be T. So this is the extended incident ray, this is the extended emergent ray, and the angle between this extended incident ray and extended emergent ray is called angle of deviation. I will represent with the letter D. From triangle TMN, observe the triangle T, M and N. This angle is I1, so here this angle also become I1. So here this small angle is R1 So this angle will become I1 minus R, minus R1, I1 minus R1. Similarly, here also this angle will be I2 minus R2. Okay, from triangle TMN, this is the exterior angle. So we know that exterior angle is equal to sum of opposite interior angles. So from triangle TMN, exterior angle is equal to sum of opposite interior angles. So the exterior angle is angle D. So D is equal to sum of opposite interior angles. So this opposite interior angle is I1 minus R1 plus I2 minus R2. So from here I will get D is equal to I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. So this will be my first equation. Let us consider triangle PMN. So from triangle PMN, let me draw that triangle PMN. So this is a triangle PMN. So we know that sum of angles in a triangle is 180. And see, this is a normal. Normal always makes an angle of 90 degrees with the surface. So from this angle will be 90 degrees, right? Now this angle we know R1. So how, what will be this angle, ma? This angle will be 90 minus R1. So similarly, this angle will become 90 minus R2. So we know that sum of angles in a triangle are 180. So angle A plus angle 90 minus R1 plus 90 minus R2 is equal to 180. So I will get A plus 90 minus R1 plus 90 minus R2 is equal to 180. So I will get A plus 180 minus R1 plus R2 is equal to 180. So we'll get A minus R1 plus R2 is equal to 0. So from here, A is equal to R1 plus R2. So this will become my second equation. So from equations 1 and 2, we get angle of deviation D is equal to I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. This is our first equation. So here I am substituting R1 plus R2. So I1 plus I2 minus A. So this is my third equation. This equation gives the relation between the angle of prism, angle of deviation, angle of incidence and angle of emergence. So from Snell's law, we know that N1 sin I is equal to N2 sin R. So applying Snell's law at M. So let us look into the diagram. So here we are applying Snell's law at point M. N1 is in air medium, so we will get 1 and I will be I1, and N2 is the refractive index of prism N and R is equal to R2. So at M, N1 is equal to air medium, that is 1, and I is equal to angle of incidence I1, N2 is equal to N, that is the refractive index of the prism, and R is the refracted ray, that is nothing but R1. So from now applying the same formula, n1 is 1 into sin I is sin I1 is equal to n2 is n sin R1. So sin I1 is equal to n sin R1. So this is my fourth equation. Now let us apply Snell's law at point n. So at point n, n1 is the refractive index of the prism n, and I will be the R2, as I said. Now n2 will be 1, that is air medium, and R is equal to I2. Let us just look into the figure once again. So at this point we are applying Snell's law. N1 is the refractive index of the prism and N2 is an air medium. So this is the incident ray. So this incident ray is making some angle, that is R2. So angle of incidence will be R2, and the ray is emerging out. So this is the refracted ray. So the angle of refraction is I2. So applying Snell's law at N, we get N sin R2 is equal to sin I2. So this is our fifth equation. At a particular angle of incidence, the angle of emergence will be equal to angle of incidence. That is, I1 is equal to I2. When I1 is equal to I2, the angle of deviation D will be called as minimum deviation capital D. So when I1 is equal to I2, the angle of deviation will become capital D. This capital D is called deviation. So at minimum deviation, we will get I1 is equal to I2. So when I1 is equal to I2, we will get minimum deviation, that is D. And we know that when I1 is equal to I2, we will get R1 is equal to R2. So from equation 3, that is D is equal to I1 plus I2 minus A. Here I am applying I1 is equal to I2. So I will get D is equal to I1 plus I1 minus A. So I will get D is equal to 2I1 minus A. So D plus A is equal to 2I1. So from here I will get I1 is equal to D plus A by 2. So let us take this equation as equation number 6. So from equation 2, A is equal to R1 plus R2. So A is equal to R1 plus R1. So A is equal to 2R1, which implies R1 is equal to A by 2. Let us take this equation as equation number 7. Now let us substitute 6 and 7 in equation 4. So from equation 4, we got sin I1 is equal to n sin R1. So sin I1 is A plus D by 2 is equal to n into sin A by 2. N is the refractive index of the prism. So here we are deriving the equation for n. So I'll get n is equal to sin A plus D by 2 by sin A by 2. So finally we got the expression as n is equal to sin A plus D by 2 by sin A by 2. So this is the required formula for refractive index of the prism. Here A is called the angle of prism and D is called the minimum deviation. And N is called the refractive index of the prism. Refractive index of prism. Hope you all understood the derivation part.